first R of relationship giving then is revelation. Now, revelation is just a fancy word for understanding. When we give out of revelation, it means that we understand why we give. With anything that we do, the why is so important. And this is what I want to start with here, that we understand how and why we give. I want to try and root all three of these in the clearest picture that we see of giving in the New Testament, 2 Corinthians 9, and draw revelation and radical and regular out of that. The context here is Paul, again, the apostle writing to the Corinthians, and they have told him that they will be ready to give a gift to the saints in Jerusalem. And he has gone around to the other churches boasting that the Corinthian church will give so much money. Now he writes to them and says, listen, I'm coming to collect that gift, so you better be ready. Because if you're not, I will be embarrassed and you will be embarrassed. So we're going to pick this up, 2 Corinthians 9 and verse 3. I'm sending the brothers so that our boasting about you may not prove empty, so that you may be ready as I said you would be. Otherwise, if some Macedonians, we'll talk about them, come with me and find that you are not ready, we would be humiliated, to say nothing of you. So I thought it necessary to urge the brothers to go on ahead and arrange in advance for the gift you have promised, so that it may be ready as a willing gift, not as an exaction. The point is this: whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. Whoever sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Each one must give as he has decided in his heart, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound to you, so that having all sufficiency in all things at all times, you may abound in every good work. As it is written, he has distributed freely, he has given to the poor, his righteousness endures forever. He who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will supply and multiply your seed for sowing and increase the harvest of your righteousness. Last verse. You will be enriched in every way to be generous in every way, which through us will produce thanksgiving to God. Again, so much in there, but let me talk about this thing of revelation. There are at least two revelations, two understandings that you must have if you will give with joy, if you will give freely and cheerfully, if you will employ relationship giving in your life. The first is that God is the great giver. He is the one that has given to us first. So often we think that we have to give so that we can receive, but the reality is, the truth is that God has given first. We give because we have received. The scripture is so clear here. It says that God is the one who supplies the seed for sowing and also the bread for eating. He's the one that supplies. He's the one that has distributed freely. He doesn't look and see, okay, well, who's the one that has given the most? Let me give to them. No, he distributes freely. And he supplies not only the bread, but also the seed. That which we sow, he supplies that. So this is a radical change of mind that we must have, that he's the one that is given first. And as we have received, we are able, we are empowered to give. We don't give because we want to get something from him. I believe that's a radical mind shift change that will really help you. We give out of thanksgiving. We acknowledge, wow, we've received so much, and that enables us to give. The second thing that I believe that we must understand is that giving is the gift that keeps on giving. Even though we don't give to receive, we give because we have received. When we give, we will continue to receive because we are sowing seed in the ground that will produce fruit. God has put this principle of sowing and reaping in the earth, and we see this here. Paul says, if you sow sparingly, you will reap sparingly. If you sow bountifully, you will reap bountifully. What does that mean? Well, here's a simple analogy. I have kids. I have a daughter, Leah Jean. She's 6 years old now. If I were to give her some money, it wouldn't depend on what she did to deserve that. I would give her pocket money every week and she would get that from me. I would bless her with that irrespective of her behavior. But if she decided then to take some of that money and invest that money would provide a return for her as well. She would receive the money that I give to her irrespectively, but she would also receive the money, the return that she's getting from her investment. And this is the idea of sowing and reaping. of giving and receiving. God gives to us. I believe we are blessed with every spiritual blessing. He distributes freely. Even when we don't give, He gives. But when we give, it's seed in the ground that will produce fruit. It's an investment that will bring a return. And investing, friends, in the kingdom, investing in the church and the ministry and the vision of the church, the calling of the church, I believe that has got a radical return on it, an eternal return. So here's the first revelation that we must have when we're going to give appropriately, according to relationship, from the heart, is that God is the giver. He supplies the seed. He's the one that distributes freely, and we give as a response. But also, as we give in response to Him, that giving will keep on giving. We will reap even as we sow. The next video is number 2, giving radically by grace.